Good afternoon, Southern California, AM 1220 FM 98.1 KHTS. Special finance hour, Fred Arnold with David Cantrell, and with special guest today, David.
Yeah.
Love this guy.
Yeah, he's great. He's one of the best in the area, that's for sure, and best in the business, too.
Yeah. Not only that, he gives back a lot. Taylor Kellstrom with Remax Gateway. You know what I loved about Taylor is he saw a need in the city for books, and book exchange. And that was a big thing. And he opened his own book exchange, Entrepreneur, Circle of Hope, Man of the Year nominee. Hey, we're talking about you, Taylor. Welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks for having me. I'm happy to be here.
But I think his proudest accomplishment right now, other than motorcycle racing, all the...
He does a lot of marathons.
Yeah, marathons. Is him and Becca just had a baby boy, Jackson.
Yep.
Yeah, welcome.
Yep.
And congratulations. Yep. 8 months old now?
Yeah, he's 8 months.
Well... enjoy every minute. And you said he took his first step, didn't he? Didn't you?
He started crawling now. So he's starting to go mobile, which definitely changes the game. But it's neat to see him grow and do those things. Especially, I mean, I've been working out of home a lot more the last few months. So it's been neat to see it hands-on a little bit more than I normally would have.
Yeah, and you're an overachiever, so he's going to be an overachiever, this kid.
Have you had to buy a new Laker jersey for him yet? Has he gotten that big?
Oh, I already had those prepared. He's good till he's like 3 or 4. I've got them all ready for him.
There you go.
Well, Taylor, let's jump and talk about real estate. What's going on out in here in Santa Clarita? I'm a big fan. I think it's going to be the greatest opportunity for youthful America, in my opinion, to get once in a lifetime interest rates at a time when maybe 8 or 9 people aren't bidding on a house. So what's going on out there?
Oh, absolutely. You know, and that's the neat thing about the market right now. You know, a lot of people are waiting, kind of leery, like, oh, is the pricing going to go down? I get a lot of calls about that, especially lately. And to be honest with you, if you're at that 650 mark or below, especially for first-time homebuyers, we're not going to see a dip in values. We're just not going to see it. The demand is too high. But the neat thing is right now is with such low inventory, and this whole pandemic going on, the serious buyers are getting an opportunity to buy. Mm-hmm. They're the ones that aren't going to have to, right at this particular moment, go against, you know, 4 or 5 different offers. Right now, you might be the only offer in, or you'll just be competing against one other person at that point. So there's definitely opportunity right now for the serious buyers, especially interest rates are so low. And inventory, yeah, it is low, but there is an opportunity to get what you want at this particular time.
Well, you know, Taylor, rates have gone down at least 1% over the last year or so, a year and a quarter. I got a client right now on the SpaceX, works for SpaceX in their, machinist, mm-hmm. You know, just a hardworking kid. And he calls me and says, I'm ready. He's been locked out of the home buying process for the last year and a half.
Right.
Multiple offers, makes an offer, they accept his. There was only 2 other offers and one of the hottest markets in Orange County. So it's out there, isn't it?
It's definitely out there. And I think a lot of things too, people are leery of, especially with their money at this particular time. A lot of people, I get phone calls, you know, just like 2008 when the market crashed. And to be honest with you, real estate, in my professional opinion, is actually what's going to pull us out of this recession that we're in right now. Back in 2008, there was not much equity for people. At this particular moment, 55% of all the homes in California have 50% or more equity. So people do have equity in their homes, so they are able to sell and move up and capitalize on these opportunities that are out there right now. And also with rates being what they are, and the other difference between, you know, 2008 and today is rents are much higher. Back in the day, it made sense for people to walk away from their home because they could rent the same home for cheaper than their mortgage. That's not the case today. So, and I think too, when you talk about first-time home buying in the market that we're in right now, I know everybody starts to think like that, about the house payment, but it's really about the long-term investment and making money. If you have a 3% appreciation, and let's say your interest rate is 2.875, 3%, somewhere in that range. You're paying down that loan about $9,000 to $11,000 a year. Well, think about it. Let's just use a number of $10,000 a year. After 5 years, you just made $50,000 on your money with making your house payment, let alone the tax write-off that you are now getting. And you've got a 3% appreciation over those years. You've just now made $150,000 with your 3% down.
Yeah.
What can you do to make you that kind of money in 5 years? You're already doing the work. You're already paying for something, whether that's rent or whatnot. You're letting your money work for you long term. And that's how we need to start to see things with our first-time home buyers and kind of guide them as a point of this is what's good for you and your family and moving forward in life.
You know, I don't know about you, Dave, but when I bought my first house, you know, I had half the money.
Mm-hmm.
And my father-in-law lent me the other half, and it was not a lot of money. It was maybe $20,000, right?
Right.
I paid him back within a year. Some people don't have, you know, that resource, so
right.
they can go 3% down. Some right. people don't have that. They go 401k. Some people don't have that. They go 3% down. Some people don't have that. They go VA, no money down. So there's
right.
ways to do it, isn't there?
Absolutely. There's many, many different ways to do it. There's definitely not one formula for this. There are, you know, different programs, different down payments. You just need to talk to a professional and have them help you walk it through. So
that's absolutely correct. I mean, there's a million ways to slice the pie. And I think that's one of the biggest myths, though, too, is our first time home buyers, pretty much all their life, they're told they need 20% down. And that's not true.
Right. We just discussed that, how you can definitely, there's, you know, 3.5% down. There's some programs with 3% down or even five, you know, that's the amazing thing is when I start talking to these people is telling them, no, you can put 5% down. They're like, what? And their eyes just light up because they're like, well, wait a minute. We might have that already.
Yeah. Yeah. You know,
exactly.
Taylor, we only have about 3 minutes. So I want to bring up a topic that I'm passionate about, Dave, if you don't mind. And that is ADU, you know, buying a place, first house, and yeah, it's just going to be you and a friend maybe, or you and a significant other. Why not convert the garage mm-hmm. to an ADU? Let's talk about that.
Yeah, you know, there's ways to go ahead and do that and get the permitting and like that to convert the garage and to make it into another room or whatnot. And I know that you have a little bit more experience, you know, talking about that. There's definitely a million different ways to do that. And that's the thing, like, people don't, like, kind of going back to first-time home buyers, if you're renting a house with three other people, you might as well figure out how you could even just buy a house in that same capacity, and now you've all got your money working for you as well. So, I mean, there's ways to, you know, go on loans with a friend or a family member and be able to do that. I had a client that the mom couldn't qualify, but she had the daughter living with her, and for the next 3 to 5 years, they saw that the daughter would still be there. They ended up using the daughter's income as well, and they were able to buy their house together. You know, the father had passed away a few years prior, and this was a way that we were able to help them and get them into a place that they owned on their own.
Yeah, so just ADU, auxiliary unit dwelling, correct?
ADU, auxiliary dwelling unit.
Right. Yeah.
So. It allows you to convert a room into a full kitchen and all
right.
that good stuff.
Right,
know?
Right.
So, yeah. Taylor, those who want to reach out to you, how can I get you?
Real simple, 661-714-8915, and I'm available 24/7.
Your email?
It's my first and last name, so Taylor Kellstrom, 271@hotmail.com.
Dave, yours?
Email david@affloans.com.
Yep, Fred Arnold, fred@fredarnold.com. Special hour.
Yep.
We're going to do this for the next month or two. Give tips on, you know, creating a new tomorrow. And not being afraid of what's going on, not be afraid of taking advantage of a lot of opportunities out there.
Right, there yeah. are.
Until we talk next week, Fred Arnold, Dave Cantrell, AM 1220, FM 98.1, KHTS. Yes, I do.